You earn your stripes on the court. It's not personal. It's really just business.
Oh, it was very personal for Pip.
That was personal for Pip. Oh, yeah, it was personal.
Because Jerry Krause wanted to pay this dude and like praise him and call him the next great thing. And he still hadn't really renegotiated Pip's contract. And then Pip just took it as disrespect. Yeah. As anybody in his situation probably would.
That's a fact. Mm-hmm. Anybody else would react that way, and I love that. I think I love how we got to get a glimpse of how Jordan can say, yo, today.
Oh, yeah.
Today's the damn
clamps.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Clamps on
so,
today.
Like, when Jordan, like, wants to turn it on, like, and we've seen it multiple times during this doc, like, it would either it'd be a player comparison or it would be a this person can defend Jordan or whatever the case could be. Once those words are said, like, bro,
you don't have a chance.
Yeah, it's over. Those are probably the worst things you can say. If you say he could stand in Jordan's shoes or his shadow, Jordan's like, he'll never stand close to my shadow again.
That was the Clyde Drexler shit.
Yeah, that was the Clyde Drexler and buddy from the Suns.
Dan Marley. When people were saying Dan Marley was a great defender, a great perimeter defender.
Yo, bro, like, listen to that Jordan quote. Buddy said, I knew that I had to bring it to him. Because if I did not, and for whatever reason, he had stopped me, people would mention him in the same sentence as me, and that couldn't happen. That's enough to set me off, bro.
Did you see a clip? That's a preview of next week's episodes.
The glove.
Where he's looking. Yeah. You showed me the clip.
Yeah.
And he's, the glove. He's looking at this video of Gary Payton saying, like, I figured out how to guard him late in the series.
Yeah.
And MJ can't stop laughing. He can't hold back his laughter.
He is hysterically laughing at this moment. Because, like, and it's a different swag to know that you're the best.
And then another thing that stood out to me in episode 5, in his last game in Atlanta, Michael Jordan played his last game in Atlanta in a football stadium.
62,000.
Because they couldn't meet the demand of putting him in the regular, like, Atlanta Hawks basketball stadium. That, to me...
No Jumbotron either, by the way.
No Jumbotron. You niggas just want to be in the building.
You ever been to Barclays?
Yes.
Right? So you ever had somebody's like, yo, I got tickets, and it's like, nosebleeds, whatever, no big deal. That's up top.
But that's dangerous in Barclays. Barclays is dangerous as fuck.
Yeah, Barclays.
You slip on a ketchup packet, it's a wrap for you.
Down there.
Straight down.
But it's high, and when you're that high up, you're like, yo, I'm going to just watch. I just prefer to watch the game on the Jumbotron.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine 62,000 people are just watching this small ass court. Like, did you see the stadium? You're watching a small, like, a basketball court. A basketball game is very, very far away when you're up top in the nosebleeds. And there's no Jumbotron to see replays or whatever. Yeah. But, like, people just wanted to be in the room.
It's even in music. It's that difference between art. Sorry, I can't fucking talk. It's that difference between artists that sell out arenas and stadiums and those artists that sell out nightclubs.
Right.
It's like, are you gonna sell out the Garden?
Yeah.
Taylor Swift. Are you gonna sell out Staples Center?
Right.
Are you gonna sell out MetLife Stadium? The switch and like the line that's
Spanish, those Spanish artists sell out MetLife.
Yeah, Aventura and Bad Bunny. They sell that shit out with it's the first
2,000 just women.
Yes.
And like 5 poppies.
I gotta make it to one of those one day.
I'm gonna go. Free pass.
Five poppies, all with the same jeans on.
Yeah, oh yeah, and good pointy shoes and tucked in black tees. I'm not gonna go off on a potato with you.